Well, it's been a pretty tough year for retailers in Australia. Sales in the first quarter were very flat, and while they picked up in the second quarter, analysts have really put that down to some pretty heavy discounting, particularly by the department stores. And really, we put this down to the effect that the overseas entrants are having in the market, particularly for the apparel retailers. Having said that, some segments in the market are quite strong. The supermarkets are still doing quite well, and Bunnings keeps going from strength to strength. Well, I think there's two main reasons why our online retail landscape is not developing as fast as in other countries, and they are firstly our geography and secondly wages. In relation to our geography, the reality is we're a very big country and we're sparsely populated. So in terms of the delivery times and so forth that are required for online retailers, they just can't meet the demands here that they could do overseas. In relation to wages, relatively speaking, our wages are quite high compared to other countries. And although there was some relief for retailers earlier this year with the penalty rates decision cutting rates on a Sunday, the reality is that that decision hasn't really kicked in because the Fair Work Commission has transitioned that cut in over 3 to 4 years. And we've only just seen a 5% reduction from 1 July 2018. Although online shopping in Australia is really taking off more slowly than in other countries, it is still having a very significant effect on the retail landscape. And so large retailers in particular and landlords have had to respond to that in a number of different ways. The main way that we see them responding more recently is to really focus on making the shopping experience very exciting. And so there's a real focus now on experiential shopping and making it an attraction for shoppers to come to large department stores and to large shopping centres. Well, in terms of the challenges that the retail industry will face in 2018, there's probably two significant ones. The first is the spectre of Amazon. We've already seen the effect that's had on the retail landscape this year, and that's probably only going to heighten next year. The other is really around wages and enterprise bargaining agreements. There's a great deal of flux in the retail sector at the moment, particularly with the larger retailers, around what they're going to do with their enterprise agreements. In terms of trends, look, there's still lots of exciting things happening in retail, particularly with the advent of new technology. And the analysts are tipping that it's going to be a really, really big Christmas for many retailers. So I think there's still a lot to look forward to in the retail sector.